Hey, I'm here behind the camera. Hey, this fellow Phil sent me these really nice stones, and I just started to try them out, and they seem to work fantastic. Now, there's a coarse side and a fine side, and he says in the direction here, I'll set the box down. I'll get those back over there. You just rub them together until they feel smooth, and that feels smooth, and I'm using the coarse side. And I've got this antique 50 taper to 4 Morse taper adapter. And I'm not kidding, this is ancient. It's probably 100 years old. And it's all beat up, but I think it's savable. And I wanna give it a try here. And so I just started sliding a stone across there, and I immediately started picking up the burrs. Quite a bit better than with another stone I was using, which is a real small Arkansas stone, fine Arkansas. But the coarse side of this is just really nice. I haven't tried the fine side. I'll give that rub them together there. Let's see what the fine side feels like. Well, that has a nice feel to it too. You think you kind of get beat up in the knockout slot. And I think it'd really be nice if I could salvage this. It fits in the old brown and sharp horizontal spindle and the tool and cutter grinder work head. I don't know, Phil, if I'm doing it right, but it feels good. I'm gonna go back to that coarse side. Rub them. Yeah, that just, you can really start feeling it glide, and it'll catch. See, what he's done is he's precision ground these. And it's really hard to get stones flat in other ways. You can get them really good if you take three stones and rub them together and like that. But I don't, this is really kind of a unique surface for a stone that I've worked with anyway. Oh, just, I have to say, this is really, really nice. And thank you, Phil. Thanks, Phil. I'm gonna end up, I've got to deburr my tables quite often. And I'm gonna take this out to the brown and sharp table, then probably over to the chipboard and deburr that stuff too. Because you just gotta do it. Every now and then, you can't help but drop tools on things, put little nicks and stuff. But I tell you what, this feels really, really nice. I don't know if it's intended for tool shanks, but it's working quite well here. This is a Cincinnati part, and it's got a bunch of writing. I don't know if I'll be able to read it once I kind of clean it up. And this had a bit of rust, and I was using, of course, the Hoppies that Ed sent. He sent a giant bottle, but I just pour it in this little one so I don't knock over the big bottle and dump it all over everywhere. But I have to say that the Hoppies is the best rust cleaner that I found. It just is. And it seems to be important. Is a brass or copper brush, and this is a Hoppies brush. It's just you want to get some rust off some. I sound like an infomercial, but I like things that work, and these things do work. They really do. The stone is just, it's really quite amazing here. So look at this all deburred. Oh, it just feels so good right now. I'll try that fine sight again. Look, it's just exactly the right length for a 50 taper. I don't know, Phil, I think this is the best 50 taper cleaner out there. Okay, I'm gonna set that down. Let me get the camera off here. Working on these machines, you know, I just keep fixing machines. But I actually got a project to do, and it's on a kind of a machine. Let's go look at it. Out this door here, from a trip over everything. And the sun's kind of shining on it. Well, this is my old Manly press here. And the hand wheel here is stuck because it's stripped. This is the ram here is on a big long Acme thread, and you can screw it down. And I was pressing on a dirt bike crankshaft, and they really started putting the crank pins in them real tight, as tight as the Harley Davidson twin cams and stuff. And I ended up finally stripping the threads out of that, having a cheater handle in this thing. It's a 50 ton press, but it's probably doing 60 tons anyway. And so I'm gonna pull this out and somehow knock this apart, and then machine this wheel here and make a sleeve, thread it Acme, put it back together. Then I'll pull the pump off this thing too and clean that up, and maybe I'll press over that in. This little thing really needs a facelift. I'll bury the junk. All junked up in here too, working on all this stuff. Oh yeah, this is the Wahopter I got in there. And I was asked, Terry or somebody asked me about showing Wahopter tooling I made, and this is a facing bar I made for a specific cutting, a flange that has a shoulder. So I'd be cutting and it'd be feeding this way, and of course I fabricated this cutter here and ground it into a cutter grinder, and this thing could face a 12 inch flange to a shoulder. And I'll start it up, you can see the thing run right around here. I ran this thing not faster than 300, you know, 200 is pretty good. So I'll click it in here. Have a look, and we're looking at 200 there. So let's click it up. Oh, I put it in low range. Let's get it in high range here. Here we go. Okay, see, that's only 200. I got a counterweight on it to keep it balanced to a certain point. But this machine's going to run it fine. The machine weighs 5,000 pounds. And it's not even... You know, it's a little bit off-center, but I'll demo this thing. It's pretty cool. We'll do a demonstration with it. The head does an awful lot of things, so it's pretty cool. So I'm going to clean up the mess I made. Got to clean up this fabulous Monarch 10EE. And, well, I'll finish up my clean that shank up, and make that run true, and then I'll pull that press apart. And I hope you guys are having a good day. I get out here as much as I possibly can. Okay, have fun in your shop. We'll see you later. Hey, I'm back. I had one more thing to add to this video, show you a little problem I have. Now that I got this Wahopter head going here, I'm gonna have to remove this at times. and we tracked the rams all the way back into the machine to fit things on the table and have enough swing. This is almost smacking the ram there. So I gotta build a cradle to take this thing apart. It has an eye hook here, but it doesn't work very well with the thing together because it's so out of balance. So what I'm gonna do is build a wood cradle that'll grab this. I'll move the table under it and cradle it in wood so it doesn't get damaged. See, this thing flips. It's heavy. Okay, this thing weighs more than a Kurt Weiss. So I get this thing off, and then I've got the yoke to deal with. And this is solid iron too. And I think this thing weighs about two Kurt 6-inch vices. So I'll get this piece off, and then this, to get these off, I don't know if you've ever done this, and people that haven't, I'll tell you what you have to do, is you have to get one of these out first, and then the other, then it'll swing on the other, and you can work it off. So I probably have to use a cradle or that wooden box I got over there. I think it's what I did last time. So I got to efficiently be able to remove and replace this vertical attachment at times. And that's not going to be easy, but I got to make it as easy as possible so I can do it. Okay, so I'm going to figure that out. And I just thought I'd add to my load here. Okay, be back soon.